A 21-year-old university student, Louise Parry, was pronounced dead in April 2015 after having taken 8 pills of the dangerous and toxic fat burner, 2,4-dinitrophenol. At the inquest into her death, it became clear that Louise had no intention to die, but was in the midst of a very serious and untreated eating disorder. And so despite knowing the risks that DNP could potentially kill you, Louise opted to order the toxic fat burner from an online vendor based in London, Dr. Muscle Pharmaceuticals. Dr. Muscle Pharmaceuticals has since been taken down by UK government agencies. This, however, did not seem to resolve the issue, as there were a further 10 deaths related to DNP in the UK in the 3 years after Louise passed away. Despite being banned in both the United States and the UK, DNP is still widely available online to anyone who looks for it. A recently published FDA report estimated that there are currently over 100 websites that sell the stuff directly to eager customers. As someone who has struggled with body image issues in the past, as well as an eating disorder, and this is hard to admit, use DNP myself, I urge anyone who is considering using DNP
to reconsider.
DNP could very well kill you, and if it doesn't kill you, it could leave you with permanent disability. Hopefully by the end of this video, the very real dangers of DNP will become very clear. There will be links in the description below to resources for anyone struggling with body dysmorphia or an eating disorder. I recommend everyone check those resources out, as very often we don't realize we have an issue until that issue grows out of proportion and engulfs our entire lives, becoming very difficult to resolve. 2,4-dinitrophenol is a yellow crystalline solid that is often sold illegally, typically through online forums in the form of powder, tablets, or capsules. And it's proving to be very popular for its powerful fat-burning effect, specifically with bodybuilders looking to reduce their body fat percentage and better define specific muscle groups. It's also used by people outside the bodybuilding community to lose a bit of weight relatively quickly, though its use obviously comes with significant adverse effects. DNP wasn't always a fat burner, however, and even as a fat burner, it wasn't always considered unfit for human consumption. 2,4-dinitrophenol was first used by the French during the First World War to manufacture explosives. After the war, people took notice of its brilliant yellow color, and it was regularly used as a dye in the textile industry and also as a general pesticide. In the early 1930s, Morris Tainter at Stanford University realized that factory workers who regularly dealt with DNP lost vast amounts of weight, and so Morris Tainter began investigating DNP for its fat-burning qualities. And so from 1933 to 1938, DNP was freely sold over the counter to hundreds of thousands of customers looking to slim down. But the FDA eventually intervened in 1938 when it became clear that DNP was just too toxic, having caused several dozen deaths, and according to one estimate, 2,500 cases of blindness due to cataract by 1935. My name is Hashim, and I'm a University of Cambridge graduate and student doctor, and this is Dr. Tell Me Why, a medical health channel where I explain the science behind better health. Today I plan to explain how DNP burns fat, causing people to lose weight, as well as why it's considered to be too toxic or too unsafe for human consumption. I'll also go over some of the treatments available to anyone presenting with DNP toxicity, as well as give some personal anecdotes about my personal experience using DNP. This video is part 2 of a 3-part series. Once you're done watching, feel free to check out part 1, link in the description below. Part 1 was all about the black market supplement Cardarine and the science behind how it improves athletic performance, as well as some of the risks involved when taking it. The final part of the series will come in about 2 weeks' time, so if you'd like to watch that, make sure you subscribe. The first thing that anyone who has ever taken DNP will tell you is that you will feel hot. So unbearably hot. I remember taking DNP in the UK in the middle of winter, and it was basically snowing outside, and I was in shorts because I felt absolutely nothing. I was actually really, really warm, panting, trying to cool myself down, and also sweating profusely. I woke up every single morning with my sheets, bed sheets, soaked. This is because DNP will raise your core body temperature and increase your basal metabolic rate by a substantial amount. Most estimates suggest that consuming just 100 mg of DNP a day is enough to raise your basal metabolic rate by 11%, and this is enough to result in around 1 pound of weight being lost each week. Most of the people using DNP, however, will be looking for much quicker results. Many online forums recommend taking up to 400 mg of DNP each day, which significantly accelerates the weight loss. Personally, I was taking around 400 mg a day and managed to lose 6 pounds in a single week. It's worth noting that I lost all that weight without doing any meaningful exercise. There were days where I genuinely struggled to get out of bed, and despite having a pretty ravenous appetite where I was basically eating everything and anything and consuming in excess of 3,000 calories each day, I was still managing to lose weight. The DNP was burning through all that food and so much more. This is because DNP really does cook you from the inside out. There were days where I lay in bed and genuinely wondered if I was going to die, if I had taken too much DNP and this was going to be it. It didn't matter how much water I drank because I was always dehydrated, hot, and a little delirious, which makes reports of people taking an extra dose of DNP accidentally
very easy to believe.
When you're on DNP, your head is in the clouds, you're a little bit delirious at all times, you're feverish and you're also dehydrated, which just kind of makes you out of it. And so it's very easy to take an extra dose of DNP accidentally, one that you did not intend to take. And very often that extra dose of DNP is all it will take to push your body over the edge. Temperatures above 40 degrees centigrade are not uncommon with DNP, and there have been reports of dinitrophenol raising core body temperatures up to 44 degrees centigrade, with often fatal consequences. This acute hyperthermia is often the cause of death. Other causes of death that have been reported include cardiac arrest and acute kidney failure. Those who survive can sometimes end up losing muscles, which literally just die and go on to need amputations. Others taking much lower doses, as low as 100 mg a day, can go on to complain of hearing and vision impairment as well as peripheral neuritis, a condition affecting the peripheral nerve which often presents with numbness, weakness, and even pain. But how does dinitrophenol do all this? DNP uncouples oxidative phosphorylation. This means it gets into the mitochondria, the organelle that's present in every single one of your cells, and is responsible for turning energy-rich glucose into actual energy that your cells are able to use, ATP. And it breaks this vital link. And hence, glucose is consumed, but its consumption does not lead to the production of ATP. It's not actually the ATP molecule that holds the energy, but the chemical bonds between adenosine and the phosphate groups that hold the energy. And under normal circumstances, glucose will be spent within the mitochondria to build up a proton electrochemical gradient, which can then be used to build up these chemical bonds between adenosine and the phosphate groups, turning adenosine diphosphate, or ADP, to adenosine triphosphate, or ATP. When DNP is present, however, it allows the protons to leak, a process which is very exothermic, releasing a lot of heat. And so instead of releasing useful energy for your cells in the form of ATP, your cells begin producing heat. I wasn't joking when I said that DNP cooks you from the inside out. And so, when your body finds itself low on ATP, its currency for energy, it does the only thing it knows to do. It tries to compensate for that by burning through its carbohydrate and fat reserves, often leading to even more heat being released. But DNP isn't actually the only chemical that does this. It's actually a fairly weak uncoupler of oxidative phosphorylation. There exist other much more powerful uncouplers of oxidative phosphorylation that are just so powerful that no one uses them for anything because
they would just kill you.
These uncouplers include FCCP and CCCP. Now, you may be wondering if there is a specific antidote that we can give people who present to the emergency room with DNP toxicity. And the answer is no. There is no specific antidote for DNP and treatment is largely supportive. If a patient presents early enough, you may try activated charcoal. However, it's important to remember that DNP is likely a class 1 molecule, meaning that it's very small and very lipophilic and hence rapidly absorbed from your gut into your bloodstream. Which means that activated charcoal is unlikely to be beneficial after 1 hour post-ingestion. Aggressive fluid resuscitation is often required for dehydrated or unconscious patients. Benzodiazepines are often needed for patients who are agitated or presenting with seizures, as DNP can often cause the elevated body temperatures needed to instigate seizures. Dantrolene and ice baths have been used to try and cool patients down. The use of dantrolene, however, is relatively controversial, as there really is no evidence to recommend its use except for a single case report, which is just the anecdotal report from the treatment of one single patient. In conclusion, the key to managing DNP poisoning or cases of DNP poisoning is having a high index of suspicion, as well as being able to recognize cases early enough to begin supportive treatment. DNP should clear out of the system within 3 to 4 days, usually through urine, except in cases of impairment of kidney function, bearing in mind that DNP itself impairs kidney function. I have no shame in admitting that I was extremely stupid in using DNP. I was 19 years old and frankly very reckless. I also hated everything about my body and was extremely uncomfortable with all the weight that I'd gained in my first year at university. And so DNP seemed like a very attractive choice. After all, the supplement market is saturated with fat burners, so how bad could DNP really be compared to all these other fat burners?
Like, very bad.
I just didn't think carefully about the consequences, because I was 19 years old. And really reckless. I was also desperate and really struggling. I had struggled with my weight in the past and I'd done things that I really don't want to talk about here. And I just felt like I wasn't very well supported and was making a lot of bad decisions. And so to keep this short and sweet, I think you will all be very glad to know that I'm doing much better now. I have a much healthier mindset. I've had this much healthier mindset for a relatively long period of time now. And because of that healthier mindset, I'm able to make healthier decisions or better decisions that don't involve me taking DNP. I find exercise to really be one of the best ways to stay in shape and keep the weight off, as it's pretty hard to exercise or engage in sports when you're starving yourself or letting your demons get the best of you. And remember to be nice to people because you just don't know what they might be going through behind closed doors. And subscribe.
This is obviously the most important thing about all of this.